is Triple X Productions, music on steroids.
I got a good one for y'all. Why is it the South is in more control of hip hop right now than the East Coast? Why has the East Coast taken a back seat and haven't they haven't snatched the crown back after all these years? Why you guys think so? We'll start with the rapper, Freestyle.
I believe it's more camaraderie in the South. You know what I'm saying? Like the South, you know, don't mind collaborating with each other, you know, helping the next up and coming rapper out. And whereas the North, you know, everybody wanna be king of New York. You know what I'm saying? So you really got a power struggle in the North right now. You know what I'm saying? Everybody wanna be the best. When really, it ain't no best, ever. You know, who can you say you're really the best, ever? You know, I say Tupac or Andre 3000, but it's gonna be an argument, whoever you say. So it really ain't no best, man. So stop trying to be the best and just be the best at what you do and just be great at what you do.
Exactly.
And stop trying to compete with, because I really compete with myself. I'm my worst critic.
Right.
You know, so I'm the only person who I compete with, man. And once I satisfy myself, I ain't worried about satisfying nobody else, man. So I really believe that's the problem of North, man. Everybody want to be the king of, you know, whatever they want to be king of. Really, really, really not coming together. Once they come together, man, you know, who knows? You know what I'm saying? But we still got something to say. The South still got something to say.
Man, my take on it, pretty much like yours. You know, it's the camaraderie, man. It's the, you know, even from the East Coast, North Carolina, South Carolina, down to Georgia, you know, Bama, and even what they call the third coast, you know, Texas.
Right, right, right.
Man, you'll get an album now, you know, and you'll pick up a T.I. album or a Jeezy album or, you know, Outkast or whatever, you know, even when A-Ball, MJG, Bun B, Pimp C, you'll pick up one of those albums. Man, you'll hear the whole South. You know, you'll hear the whole Dirty South on the album. You know what I'm saying? Even if it wasn't with, you know, 4 bars, 8 bars, 16 bars, they still pay homage to each other. You know, and like I was saying earlier, man, you know, imitation is the best form of flattery.
Right.
You know, but up North, what it is, you got a problem with those egos.
Right.
People can't set those egos aside. You know, as soon as somebody jump on it, ah, oh, man, this dude bite my track, man. This dude bite my style. This dude you know, he trying to be like me. Can't nobody be like me. But, man, you supposed to embrace that. You supposed to say, man, hey, this dude trying to be like me? Shoot, man, I must be doing something right. You know, you take that as a good sign that you going in the right direction, because my thing is, the minute somebody stop watching you and start imitating you, you done fell off.
And no disrespect to the North, man, but it's a lot of hate now. Now, you know what I'm saying? For one, they hating on the South because we are in control.
Right.
And two, they hating on each other because they trying to be in control of each other up North.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's really hate on top of hate, you know what I'm saying? Which really, you know, has been a self-destruction.
Yeah, because, you know, think about it. In New York, you used to have, the way it used to be, and even, you know, further hip-hop in the late 70s and the 80s, you know, you had 5 boroughs.
Right.
You know, and, but you could, you know, I watched that interview with Snoop, and he said even with the 5 boroughs, you could tell who was from which borough, but at the same time, they all said, hey, man, we in it together, because they had a common cause. They had a common good, which was to spread hip-hop and to make sure that it wasn't just a one-hit wonder or, hey, we just gonna be here for 10 years and we just gonna fade out. So everybody was coming together, you know, and spread it out. And now that everybody spread out, you know, it finally made it down to the South, where, you know, as a major force, You know, now everybody beefing, you know, now everybody up there beefing with each
right,
other.
Because and, see, coincidentally, the come and go in New York now is to be the king of New York.
Right.
So now that's the ultimate downfall.
Yeah. And look, the club being on the bureaus, man, like what Snoop was saying, I remember back in the late 80s, early 90s, all the way up to mid 90s, you could hear a rapper from the East Coast, and you could immediately identify with where bureau, I mean, they repped it so well.
Right.
Like, if you said Wu-Tang, you automatically knew that's Staten Island.
Right, right,
you know what
right.
I'm saying? KRS-One, he, the Bronx, you know what I'm saying?
Nas. Queensbridge.
Queens.
Right.
You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Biggie, Jay-Z.
Right. Brooklyn.
AZ.
Right.
Brooklyn. Big Daddy Kane, Brooklyn.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Then, you know, you got Harlem, which is North Manhattan.
Dipset.
Mace. Who else? I mean, you know what I'm saying? They were
proud.
Right. Yeah, they said it loud and proud. You know what I'm saying? But I think what Atlanta was able to do, well, they was you know, of course you got your Decatur, you got your East Point, you got your College Park.
Zone 4,
Bankhead. Yeah. They repped it well, but they had no problem coming together
right.
collectively
right.
to rep one city.
Right.
And even with T.I. saying he was the king of Atlanta, it still wasn't a real problem. Like, didn't nobody, you know what I'm saying? Like, didn't nobody just have a real issue with, shit, I'm the king of Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like how they do on the East Coast. No disrespect to nobody on the East Coast, because that's their thing. And that's the reason why we all different. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But T.I. said, he was like, I'm the king of the South because I'm the first one to say it. You know?
Right, right, right.
Jesus, snowman, but he's the first one to say it.
Right. Who would have speak on that right there?
So, I mean, didn't nobody have no problem with it. They still came together. Like T.I., what was that song? He was like, you got Lil Jon, King of Crump. King's right. Crump, you know what I'm saying? Didn't nobody have no problem with, like, Lil Scrappy to come in and say, I'm the King of Crump. He was like, I'm the Prince of Crump.
Right.
You know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right,
so
right,
it was
right.
still, they was all being supportive.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Of each other. I think that's why the South, I think we're going to be here for a minute, man.
Right.
In the forefront, I really do.
And even before, you know, people give T.I. a lot of flack by saying the King of the South. But before T.I., you know, it was Nelson, Black Prince of the South.
Yeah.
Nobody ever said nothing about that. You know what I'm saying? I guess because he wasn't calling himself the King. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, he did that in respect to the forefather, you know, the ghetto boy, UGK, you know, so he called himself the Prince of the South. And you said, T.I. said it because he said it first, you know what I'm saying? I guess they go back to Christopher Columbus. Hell, I discovered America. What's that? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
What's the name? America Vespucci, I ain't
never heard of. They say
that's who really discovered America, which was an Indian. You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of sense, man, but, back to the T.I., man. T.I. really broke it down to what it made me understand, you know, what he was talking about when he said King of the South. You know what a coup means? You know what a coup means? A king of oneself.
Oh, okay.
You know, so if you believe it within yourself, you know,
yeah.
Who gonna stop you?
Yeah.
You know, that's what a
cool me,
a king of oneself.
Yeah, Charlemagne the God, he said something to that extent as far as the reason why he called himself Charlemagne the God. You know what I'm saying? He even had a scripture to support what he said. I forgot the scripture, but it's on the same page as what T.I. said.
Right, right. So, I mean, it made a lot of sense to me.
Mm-hmm.
What you think, bro?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it makes sense because, like you said, you know, and that even goes back to, you know, little kid at the playground.
Right.
You know, that's just like, if you told me, hey, call me Quake.
Yeah.
if I didn't know anybody else named Quake.
You Quake.
You Quake. If I told you to call me Sleepin'.
Yeah, you said.
Ain't nobody else named Sleepin'. I'm going to call, you know, you going to call me Sleepin'.
Yeah, yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Because I'm not trying to be nobody else. I'm trying to be me.
Then nobody try to challenge you.
I'm trying to establish my own self, my own identity. You see what I'm saying?